Hey everybody, in this video I'm going to tell you all about the different levels of reality and why people's different belief systems may seem completely incompatible but might actually match after all. So this video is going to get a little out there, so I'll warn you at the beginning, but I think you'll find it really interesting and really helpful for just navigating the world in general. But this video almost definitely will require you to have something of an open mind and might challenge some belief systems that you've been taught in the past. So if you're not willing to do that, then I recommend you turn off this video and go watch cat videos instead. Okay, what I've come to believe more and more is that there are various levels of reality that are all true simultaneously, and there seem to be, I don't know how deep this goes, but it seems like there's an infinite number of these levels of reality. And so I'll give you an example to illustrate. And by the way, if you think I'm some crazy person who's recording videos on Christmas Day, don't worry, I'm not. I recorded this 2 days before and put it on a scheduler, so I'm talking to you from the past and the future. Technology's amazing. If I were to ask you, what is a human being? You could probably give me a whole bunch of different answers. It would all be true, right? So on the very basic level, you could say a human being is a mammal with two arms and two legs. Or if I asked you, what's a human being? You could say a human being is a mass of interlocking organ systems. Or you could say that a human being is a mass of millions of little self-sustaining cells. That would also be true. Or you could say that a human being is a chemical structure of mostly carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. Or you could say that a human being is a series of low-frequency energy vibrations that take the form of matter. Or you could say that a human being is a spiritual entity enveloping a physical body. Or you could say that a human being is an individualized piece of the collective spiritual fabric that forms the universe. Now, what I hope you recognize is that all of these answers are very different from each other, but at the same time, they're all true. And the reason for that is because they're analyzing the same thing, but on a different level of reality. And I think this is important because this is what underlies all the knowledge systems that exist in the world. So, for example, you have this division between science and religion, where science describes some aspects of reality and religion describes other aspects of reality. Really, they're describing different levels of reality. And even within science and within religion, you have these various breakups. So, for example, the most simple analysis of a human being that I gave you, that it's just a mammal with two arms and two legs, I would call that's like anthropological science, right? And then if you go a level deeper, where we're systems of organs, well, now you're getting into biology. And then if we're cells, then you're getting into microbiology. And then we're life forms made of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen, well, that's the chemistry analysis. And then if we're frequency vibration creating matter, well, now you're getting into the quantum physics. You see how we're getting deeper and deeper and deeper into this. And then when we cross into the next one, we talk about how we are a spiritual entity with a physical body. Well, that's kind of the Western religious focus, right? And then when we talk about a collective spiritual fabric of the universe of which we are one individualized conscious piece, well, now you're kind of getting into the Eastern philosophy. And my belief is that they're all true. They're all true at the same time. And all these conflicts between the science and religion and between Western religion and Eastern religion and between the various branches of science, which we see all over the world all the time, everybody's in conflict. Well, they shouldn't be, because they're all describing different levels of the same reality, but they're all true. It's funny because of the way they attack each other, right? The people that are on the more, let's say, concrete side, like the anthropologists that say that humans are just mammals with arms and legs, they see the people on the quantum physics side and say, oh, those people are just pushing mumbo jumbo. You know, we're the solid science. And then the people on the quantum physics side are saying, oh, we're getting the real nature of things. Those people are just simple-minded idiots. And then science and religion are the same way, where the scientists are saying, oh, the religious people are a bunch of naive loonies who believe in this stupid woo-woo stuff. And the religious people are saying that the scientists are missing the real meaning of life. And all the fighting is really not helpful, because every single level of analysis that we're talking about here, everyone is like a map of a territory. And you know that a map is not the territory itself. By the way, if you're enjoying this video, I'd very much appreciate it if you do me a little favor and hit the thumbs up icon, because it makes me rank better in the YouTube algorithm. Leave me a comment and hit the subscribe button and the little bell icon beside the subscribe button if you want more stuff like this in the future. every map, by definition, is a simplified version of what the actual territory is. You can't possibly include all of the details of the territory into a map. Every map is always going to be incomplete. So if you have one map and I have a different map, then maybe we should both recognize that each of our map is incomplete, and we could stand to learn a little bit more of the details from the other guy's map. And there's kind of this constant contest about like which level of reality is better than which other ones. And my answer to that is the best one is the one that's most helpful at the time. And that's going to change based on the task at hand. So if your job at the moment is to try to determine which being in front of you is a human and which one's a dog, well, probably the anthropological level, the most basic level, is going to be the most helpful. If you're trying to determine how to cure cancer, then probably the microbiological level is going to be the most helpful. If you're trying to determine how you should act on this earth and how you should find your purpose in such a way that you're going to maximize the value of your own life and your own happiness, then probably the more concrete Western religion is going to be the most helpful. Right? If you go through this, you can probably figure out some situations in which each and every level of analysis here is the most helpful in that situation. And this will make your life a lot better, by the way, because if you deny that certain levels exist, right? Like you're a complete materialist who denies that anything religious exists. Well, for one thing, you're going to have a lot of cognitive dissonance because there's a lot of overlap going on. And by the way, there's going to be a lot of overlap between all of these levels. But the quantum physics level is definitely getting into the religious level. It's showing some pretty weird stuff, right? I mean, it's showing how human consciousness can affect the reality of matter, for example. But also, if you're lacking that depth, well, you're never really going to figure out what you need to do to be successful in life, right? Because you don't even have any workable understanding of what success would be. What's going to make you happy? What's going to serve your purpose? You just have no basis for any of that. So you're going to just stay miserable. And then on the other hand, if you go too abstract and you think about, oh, we're all one consciousness, then the divisions are all an illusion, well, okay, you can recognize that, and you might be right, but if you can't break that illusion, if you're stuck in that illusion, well, you're kind of in a bad way because you don't really have anything to help guide you through that illusion properly until you can get to that point of maturity where you can cast off that illusion. So anyway, that's about enough ranting for me for now. You guys have a Merry Christmas, and if you want to learn more mind-blowing stuff about this interaction between physics and spirituality, I highly recommend you check out this video. And if you want to not be greedy and not be the only person of your friends that knows this stuff, then please share this video as well. It would help me out a lot.